Of all the Midwest cities, the one I knew best was St. Paul. And it was a crook's haven that boasted Alvin Creepy Carpus, the kidnapper and bank robber whom J. Edgar Hoover anointed public enemy number one. Carpus, also known as Old Creepy, goes on to say, every criminal of any importance in the 1930s made his home at one time or another in St. Paul.
East to the west, we deep in this cold mess. Some killers and thieves scheming to hold checks. Scratch the paper, looking who to fold next. For greenery and cheese pop up like mold specks. Don't get rolled next like a stop sign or a drop dime when I rhyme. Yeah, shots fired on the mic, bucking like a drive-by. Cut your lifeline like your palms lying, falling down on your bike ride. We're trying to bubble like peroxide, make you start crying. St. Paul, we out here climbing, little bitch.
Look at this motherfucker.
Motherfucker, what it do? All the way from Dampin' Dan to Plooky Duke. The capital city, underground just like our roots. Scuff your shoes, trying to run from these rugged goons. Thugs and droogs on drugs in an ugly mood. The crook's haven, best believe no fucking fluke.
But this is the epicenter of 1930s crime in the era of John Doe. Basically, the police in St. Paul at the turn of the century sent the word out to gangsters, bank robbers, kidnappers, come to St. Paul. You can be here. You have to promise not to kill or rob anyone within the city limits of St. Paul, and of course pay a bribe. As long as you're on your good behavior, Mr. John Dillinger.